What if I told you that in many cases, the Amex Green Card holds its own or even beats out the Amex Gold and Platinum cards? I'll admit, this card hasn't always been on my radar, but after diving deep into it, this is the card that I'll be applying live here in this video, even before getting the Amex Gold or being near Chase's 524. Because even if you purely look at the multipliers on the card, things already stand out, like getting 3x on travel, which includes your typical flights, hotels, car rentals, and more, but works on both Amex Travel and third-party sites. And that latter part is huge. If we compare to the Amex Gold, the 3x on that card is only for flights, and only for flights that are booked through the airline or Amex Travel. Even if you look at the top tier $695 Amex Plat, you'll get a higher 5x points, but only on certain limited cases, none of which are anywhere near as flexible as the 3x on general travel that the green card has. But to take it a step further, you'll also get 3x on transit, like trains, taxis, Ubers, buses, parking, and more, which is really unique to American Express's lineup of cards. Close it out by getting 3x on dining at restaurants worldwide, with takeout and delivery in the US and 1x on everything else, and that's a really well-rounded card. I'd say other than groceries, which I would still prefer the Amex Gold, this card covers the majority of important categories for most people. From ones who travel a fair amount and like the convenience of booking however they want, to ones who commute to work or can leverage that transit multiplier, to ones who eat out a lot locally or when they're traveling. But how much exactly is those 3x points worth? Well, there are plenty of ways you can use these Amex points, but at the bare minimum, you can cash them out for statement credit at a measly 0.6 cents per point, which would pin those categories at just an equivalent of 1.8% cashback. Personally, I would never cash out my points in this way, because if I'm going to jump through hoops or try optimizing my credit card spend, then I'm gonna want much more than 2% back in value, given I can get 2% on a basic card like the Citi Double Cash. There is also the option to cash out to your Schwab account through the Schwab Platinum card at 1.1 cents per point, which will pin the multipliers at an equivalent of 3.3% cashback, which is actually not that bad, but also isn't too far off from other cards like the Chase Sapphire Preferred, or getting 3x on a ton of categories on the Capital One Saver One. No, in my opinion, most people who are optimizing their credit card spend will be redeeming Amex points through one of their travel partners, which usually gives an average of about 2 cents per point, which will pin those multipliers at an equivalent of about 6% cashback. Now we're talking value. And if we look through the partners, a few really stand out. Take ANA, for example, one of the best airlines and a program that probably has one of the best redemptions out of all these programs. Like using just 95,000 points transferred one-to-one from Amex to book a round-trip business class flight over to Asia, a flight that could cost $10,600. Even if we deduct fuel charges from that amount, let's say $10,000, that's still giving our points a value of 10 cents per point. You will need to put in a lot of work though to find availability, usually either 2 to 3 weeks out or about a year away from now, like 355 days or so, but the value is there. Or you can transfer points over to Aeroplan. The value is slightly lower at 55,000 points each way on a similar route, or 110,000 points, but you'll pay much less in those fees and taxes, probably around $100 to $200 or so, and have the ability to book one-way flights. This is the transfer route I've done for two of my major trips this year. Aeroplan will also see much more Singapore Airlines availability compared to most, but you can also transfer to KrisFlyer directly and book through their own program, flying on products like their First or Suites. Now, it's going to be hard to spend to get enough points for some of these flights. Say you were booking a one-way business class flight on Aeroplan. To get 55,000 points, you'll need to spend $18,333 on a 3x category to get that many points. But that's why for most cards, the Amex Green included, the bulk of the value of these cards comes from the welcome bonus. Now, usually the bonus hovers around 40 to 50,000, but as of the time of this filming, there's an elevated offer of 60,000 points, as well as 20% back on travel and transit up to $200 back. Meaning at 2 cents per point, this welcome bonus is valued at $1,200 from the 60,000 points, as well as the $200 from the cashback, totaling $1,400, all for just $3,000 of spend over 6 months, which is double that compared to most other cards. And that bonus is more than enough to cover the $150 annual fee that comes with the card. That said, there are a couple credits to help cover that cost, but I would say they aren't as awesome as credits on the Amex Platinum or the Uber and Dining credits on the Amex Gold. Although for someone who doesn't have that many cards or is just getting into the travel credit card game, this card can still pack a punch given it's pushing into the higher tier credit cards, which is reflected in the annual fee. First off, the $189 in Clear credit is a huge quality of life booster for most travelers. Now you might wonder, what's the difference if you already have TSA PreCheck, Global Entry, or even Nexus? Well, there's actually two parts to passing security. One is the lineup to get checked at the security officer, and two is then going through the actual security machines. Clear is what helps with part one, letting you skip that entire initial line to get to the screening machines. If you then combine it with PreCheck, then your experience gets really enhanced because then you can go to a special line or don't need to take out things from your bag, your belt, or take off your shoes. The only downside is there are other cards like the Amex Platinum that do offer this Clear credit, so if you have both cards, it may not be valued at the full $189. Or maybe you don't travel that often, then you may want to reduce the value you give to this credit. Next, there's also the $100 to Lounge Buddy every year. So how this works is you go on Lounge Buddy, you choose the airport, and then look at what lounges accept booking through their portal and offering day passes. You can then purchase these passes and have that $100 credit applied to your card. On the other hand, if you already have access, you can use this to pay for additional guests to come in with you. So taking a look at a few airports like SeaTac, there are a couple lounges for $50 a traveler, so basically 2 visits a year, although clicking through the images, they're not that spectacular. But if you look at an airport like Singapore, which I'll be visiting later this year, there are a few options that seem much, much better and cheaper, as is the case for most international lounges. Now, you may not value these day passes at full value, sometimes even half or less depending on the lounge, but it does help a bit, and along with the $189 in Clear credit, does help to try and counter the $150 in annual fees. But even if we disregard those credits, the welcome bonus alone, even just that $200 portion, is enough to cover the first year annual fee. Combined with the points, it's like giving you a free card for the first year, as well as a one-way business class ticket over to Asia. If after the first year you do not find value of the card, unfortunately there is no downgrade path for the Amex Green, given it's already the bottom-most card in the Green, Gold, and Platinum card setup. That means if you don't find value of this card, you could try and see if there's any offers like retention offers, but the only alternative is to cancel the card. Who knows? Maybe they'll add a fourth card to this lineup in the future, but given Amex usually targets the more luxury crowd, I wouldn't count on that. Though on the other hand, it's possible you could get upgrade offers to cards like the Gold and Platinum, with some data points online showing offers of 20 to 25,000 points, sometimes even if you already have the card. Alright, so why do I want the Amex Green? I already have the similar Chase Sapphire Preferred, I've always wanted the Amex Gold, I already have the Amex Platinum, and I'm nowhere near Chase's 524. So why am I applying for the Amex Green? Well, there's a few reasons to consider. First, there's some data points to suggest that Amex doesn't do hard pulls if this is your second card onwards with them. This would be especially helpful given I already have the Amex Platinum card and I want to keep my score as high as possible given I'm just about to apply for an auto loan and I really want the best rates I can. Two, I'm actually right in the middle of planning and booking a major trip later this year for 3 to 5 people people across 4 to 5 weeks. That's a lot of spend that I want to put to work, which also means that when the trip comes around, I probably want another card to spend on during that trip. Maybe a Chase card or maybe the Amex Gold, given the 4 times in dining internationally. A nice little benefit is that a lot of the things I'm booking now would be considered as travel or transit, like the JR passes in Japan. So the 3 times categories will apply and earn me a nice extra chunk of points. Speaking of the Amex Gold, the third reason is that I missed the high offer on Amex Gold of 90,000 points and $200, so maybe that will come back soon. And then the fourth small reason is that I'm going with a larger group, meaning I can use the Lounge Buddy credit to add additional guests so they can come in with me to different lounges. It would be weird if, say, 3 people go in and you leave like 1 person outside. Also, even though it might be an expensive setup with 150 on the green, 250 on the gold, and 695 on the platinum for a total of 1095, there are a ton of credits to help offset that cost. They also cover a pretty wide range of categories too, with general travel and transit on the green, dining and groceries on the gold, and enhanced travel experiences on the Amex Platinum. All right, so before applying, just to lay out some data points here, my credit score is around 780 to 790, at least according to Credit Karma, with about 8 or so credit cards, with my last application being about 2-3 months ago. On the Amex side, I've had the Platinum for about 5 years now, as well as recently getting the Amex Business checking account with the debit card. I also already checked for any pre-approvals, both on Amex's own site as well as CardMatch, but did not get targeted for any offers on the Amex screen. I also never got any physical mail about this offer, so the only thing left to do is go through the application. Fortunately, the process does let you check if you're approved without impact your credit score, so hopefully it'll be good, but let's see. Okay, cool. So now that we're on the application process, let's go over what to fill and where. Like I mentioned earlier at the top of the page, you'll see that you can know if you're approved for this card with no impact to your credit score, which essentially means that they won't do a hard pull to know if you're approved. On the right side, we can verify if we're applying for the right card, so the Amex Green, as well as the right offer, which is 60,000 points after $3,000 of spend in the first 6 months, as well as the 20% back on eligible travel and transit over the first 6 months as well. Then if we scroll down, we'll see language to say that you won't be eligible for this welcome offer if you've had this card before, but there's usually a pop-up later if you try to submit the application, but won't be eligible for the bonus. Cool, so the application is pretty straightforward, but first things first, you'll want your first name and last name with the middle name if you have one, as well as your date of birth, email address, phone number, and address. That is pretty normal for most applications. So let me quickly go over and fill those out. Cool, so now we're on to your SSN number. So if you have American credit history or you're American, then nothing special here. But Amex does have a special partnership with Nova Credit, which will let you use your credit history in one of these countries listed and use that credit history to help you get approved for these cards in the US. I never use this, but I am from Canada, so if I were just getting my first card here, this could be helpful for getting approved for cards I might not be able to without any credit history. Next, there's your total annual income, which includes not only your W-2 salaries, but other sources like retirement income, investments, rental properties, and more. Then they'll also ask you for non-taxable annual income. So anything that is not subject to taxes, like the list here, including Social Security, child support, and a few other things. And then of course, where that income source is from. Personally, I'm employed, so I will choose that. And I will not check this last box because I already have the Amex app, so don't need that one-time text message. Cool, so I'm gonna go ahead and fill in the rest of this application, then go to the next step. Cool, now on the next step is onto terms. So reviewing all the terms here, including your APR, seeing if I want any additional cards. I can add them later if I want to, but right now there's no additional cards that I want to add. So just going to skip this step. Cool, so good news, Kevin, you're approved. Accept your card below. There's no impact to my credit score yet, but it will get impacted when I actually accept the card and they do the hard pull. But at least I know that I am indeed approved for this card, so let's accept. Cool. Looks like it'll arrive July 12th. There's some information here as well as setting up the account, as well as everything else here. All right, so it looks like that's my 9th card, which may seem like a lot, but it's actually low compared to a lot of other people in the credit card space. One important note though is that if you're in Amex pop-up jail, which is when you get a pop-up saying that you aren't eligible for the welcome bonus, even if you may never have had the card before, there really is no clear definition on why or how to get out of it, but here are a few things to consider. Has there been anything unusual with your past use of the balance transfers, welcome bonus, or intro APRs? Have you gotten a lot of cards or hard inquiries recently? In those cases, maybe give it some time before you try again. Or if you already have Amex cards, but they maybe have been dormant, put some more spend on there before trying again so they can see that you actually spend with their cards. But if you have the card, congratulations, it's a great pickup. If not, there's a link down below if you're interested in learning more about the card. Or if you prefer alternatives that do quite a good job in some similar ways, go on and check out this video for some powerful cards. I'll see you over there.